Welcome to this second module of Modern Line of Business App Deployment with me, Simon May. In this section, we're going to be having a look at sideloading with PowerShell. And we're going to use PowerShell to complete a sideloading installation. And we'll also try removing and doing some other things with PowerShell as we go through. So what I want you to take away from this particular module is the ability to be able to install an Apex package for a particular user and to be able to provision a package for all of the users on a particular device. I also want you to be able to inventory the applications that have been installed using the slide loading process, and in fact all applications that are installed on a Windows 8 or Windows RT device. Finally, I want you to be able to remove both Apex packages that have been sideloaded and Apex packages that have been provisioned as part of the installation. The actual PowerShell to complete the installation of a Apex package is very simple. It uses add Apex package, and we provide the location of the package that we want to go and sideload. We also provide the path to any dependencies that we want to sideload along with this particular application. And those dependencies could be the resource files, such as the WinJS Apex package, that are required in order to be able to make the application work. So let's go ahead and take a quick look at using and exploring the add Apex package commandlet. So here we are on our demo environment, and we can see that we're logged in with a demo user called Alice. Alice isn't an administrator on this particular machine. I'm just going to move across to my desktop now, and we'll see the on the desktop here, I have a folder. This particular folder contains all of the normal files that you'll get if you create a Apex package using Visual Studio. So I'll have a quick zoom in and we'll take a quick look at what these files are. At the bottom here, the technetuk.apex file, that is actually the app that we want to install via sideloading onto this particular device. Next up, we see the security certificate. This is the code signing certificate which must have been used to sign the technetuk app that must also be trusted by the devices onto which we intend to sideload this particular app. In this case, we don't actually have that that code signing certificate trusted, because it is actually just a self-signed certificate that is created by Visual Studio. Next up from that, we have the add app dev package PowerShell file. It's a very long and complicated PowerShell script which actually goes through the process of developer enrolling the device that we're deploying to. That's not something that we want to do in the case of sideloading an app, because using that particular script to install the app will A, use that self-signed, but will B, actually enable the device to have any app installed on it through the sideloading process, thus potentially creating a security risk. Above this particular Apex, this set of files, is also the dependencies folder. And within the dependencies folder, we'll actually find another Apex package, which is the Microsoft WinJS Apex package. That's a set of resources that are used for HTML and JavaScript-based applications inside of Windows 8 Modern App. So let's just go back to our previous screen there and have a look at what we do with this app. As I said, we're going to use PowerShell to do this. So I'm just going to go up to the address bar, type in PowerShell ISE, and that's going to launch the PowerShell integrated scripting environment for me, which will help me to learn the PowerShell that I need to use in order to be able to sideload this app. So the very first thing I'm going to do is start typing the command that we saw earlier, the add apex package, and that provides us instantly with the correct commandlet. It also provides us with the package commandlet. The next thing I'm going to do is provide the path to the location of our apex file. And because we came here directly from Windows File Explorer, we can actually see that I can just tab through all of the files in a particular folder, and eventually I'll come across the technetuk apex package. I'm just going to hit enter here, and that's going to immediately give us an error. And the reason is that, as I said earlier, we don't trust the certificate yet that this application was signed with. So it tells us that the certificate chain couldn't be processed. In this case, what we're going to do is go and actually install that certificate onto this device. That's not something that you do in your production environment. In your production environment, you would actually get the Apex package signed with a code signing certificate that's issued by your enterprise CA or by another trusted root certification authority. Let's go down back to our folder here. I'm going to double click the code signing certificate, and I'm going to select to install this certificate. And I'm going to select to install this into the local machine certificate store. The device that we want to install the app onto has to be able to trust the codes which is being given as part of the sideloading process. So it's the local machine, not the current user, that we want to install this for. We'll say next, and that's going to prompt us administrator credentials because Alice is not a admin on this machine. Provide the right set of credentials, and then we can select whereabouts we want to install the certificate. I'm going to actually place that certificate into the Trusted Root Certification Authorities store. Because it is a self-signed cert, we will then trust all the way back up that chain. We'll say next, and hit finish. The import was successful. So let's go back to our PowerShell ISE, and we're going to provide the same command again. Except this time, I'm actually also going to have a look at the options that I can provide. And in this case, I'm going to provide the dependency path here. So let's provide the dependency path. Again, I can tab through the locations because I browsed using File Explorer. So I'll go to dependencies, and then I'll select the Microsoft WinJS 1.0 Apex file. We'll hit enter. That's going to run away and complete the installation for us. Take us back to the start screen, and you can see the application has been installed onto the start screen along with a nice tile for it. I load it up, and the app loads itself up. So that's because we had the application trusted. We had the application had the ability to sideload the application onto the device. Let's just have a quick look inside of the group policy setting that was required to make that happen. I'm going to launch the MMC, and I'm then going to go and add file, add remove snapping, I'm going to add the local group policy, in there, and of course we're logged on as, and not logged on as an administrative user, so let's go and do that. Right, MMC, we'll right click the application, select run as administrator, provide our administrator credentials, add remove snapping, complete the same thing, and then this time we can start to browse our local computer policy. Let's go into administrative template and into Windows components, and we can see app package deployment straight away at the top. And we can then select Allow Trusted App Install and set this to Enabled. Now, in this case, you can see that it wasn't configured because this device is actually a domain Windows Enterprise installation. So, in this case, I've actually don't need to configure it through the local group policy because it was all configured through group policy provided by the domain. Okay, so we've had a look at installing an app, sideloading an app using the Add Apex Package commandlet. Let's have a quick look at bring apps that are already installed on the device. There's a few different commandlets that we can use here, and a few different switches that we can use on those commandlets. The first is get Apex package, and in this case we can say hyphen all users, and that will give us all of the Apex packages that have been deployed to all of the users on this particular device. If we leave off the hyphen all users, we'll just get returned to us just the apps that are installed and available for this particular user that we're logged on with. If we wanted to get the apps that have been installed for another user, then that's fine. We can do that. We can provide the user switch, and we can provide the user's domain and username in order to be able to access those pieces of information. We can also go and get something called the Apex Package Manifest, and that has a little bit more detailed information about the application itself, but that includes the Apex Package ID, and that can be particularly useful in certain sets of circumstances, and can also for more deep PowerShell scripting that you might want to do at a later point in time. We can also create apps in an image which is not currently online. So we can do that to an offline image. And in order to do that, we would first mount the image, and then we would use the app get apex package command in order to be able to go and grab details of everything that's been provisioned as part of a particular image. So let's go ahead and switch back to our demo environment and have a look at inventorying some apps inside of this environment. Okay, so let's have a quick look at using get appx package. So as you get appx. I'll just use the package, not the manifest. And, whoops, let's go back and select which particular switches we can use. As I said, use all users. We can find a particular package name, or we can find a particular package. In this case, I'm going to start off without any of that, and it's just going to go ahead and provide all of that details for us. Could obviously go and do the same thing and provide that out into a grid view or some other nice way of being able to consume the information. Let's do that for all of the users on this particular device. And again, we'll see very much the same kind of thing, except in this case, we're not actually logged on as an administrator. Do that. You do need admin access in order to be able to access the details of another user or the all users. In fact, if we go and do that for users and provide, again, we'll get the same error. We're access denied. In that respect, it is actually secure, and we don't have to worry about particular users being denied access to particular users being able to see what applications have been installed for other users on the same device. I'm going to go back and launch the PowerShell ISE, this time as administrator. And let's get rid of the command window there. Now we'll do get appx. Package. All users. And this will list all of the appx packages that have been installed for any users on this particular device. And in fact, right down the bottom there, you can see the Technet UK app that was installed the very last thing there. And again, you can do that for any particular user on this device. So very, very handy. Let's go and see if we can do that in any other way. What other switches are available to us? We could provide a particular publisher. Let's try. So that is now listing any applications which are published by Microsoft. So if you need to go and track down a particular application to understand what the details are around it that's been provided by a particular vendor, you can filter very, very simply just on the publisher. And if we want something with a particular name, again, we can go and find things that have a particular name. Notice, though, that the name that's being used is actually this name here from the list of details. So let's just scroll up a little bit, and we will go and find our application that we had a few moments ago. In fact, let's just scroll back down. Go and do that as... Oops. See what Alice has installed. We can see that Alice has Technet UK installed. Okay. So name. And there we go. It filters it out just directly down to that Technet UK application. Now that we've done that, let's come to get provisioned appx package. And let's see what's part of the image itself. And we need to say that it needs to be online. That's now going to look at the current image as opposed to trying to find some other image that we haven't provided it that was offline. That then tells us everything which is provisioned as part of the image. So we can see the Xbox Live, we can see the Windows Photos app, we can see the Communications app, we can see Microsoft Reader and Microsoft SkyDrive. And again, if we want to do that with a particular package, we can provide that with a particular Windows directory, a particular system drive, or we can provide a scratch directory in which to be able to go and find, as you saw earlier, a few slides ago. So having looked at inventorying the applications, let's have a look at the next stage of the lifecycle and removing applications. Again, removing, very, very simple. We just type remove Apex package, and then provide the package name. We can also do the same kind of thing for removing Apex packages which are part of provisioned experience. So, okay, so let's have a look at using the remove Apex package commandlet. So let's just type in remove Apex package, and there we go. Obviously shows us the provisioned package as well. We'll provide the package string switch here as well. So let's just provide that switch. And then we need to name the switch, the actual app that we want to remove. So if I just type in TechNet, which is the app I installed earlier, that's not going to do anything for me. In fact, the same would be true if I type in TechNet with wildcards. I actually need the particular Apex package name as Windows sees it. So let's go ahead and go and inventory those apps again. So get Apex package. And there is the last one that's installed is our TechNet UK application. Now you can see that it does include the word TechNet UK in there, but the wildcard didn't actually work. In fact, it's not this short name at the top we need. We actually need to provide this particular package full name in order to be able to remove the application. So we'll go and copy that piece of information. We'll do remove Apex package, provide the package, and we'll just paste in that package name, and we can see that the app gets removed. Again, we'll go and do our get Apex package, and it will list all of the apps there, and you'll notice that when it gets down to the very end, it doesn't list the Apex package for the TechNet application. So that's taking a quick look through the removal of apps using PowerShell. We've also had a look at how we inventory apps on a device using PowerShell as well. And earlier on, we had a look at the process for sideloading an app using PowerShell, and indeed also the process for provisioning an app into an image using PowerShell. Let's go and have a look at removing a pre-installed application from our Windows image as the administrator. I'm just going to flip over to my administrator ISE, and in here I'm going to do get Apex provisioned package. Let's try that with correct typing. Provisioned package, there we go. And that's going to list all of the provisioned packages for my device. Obviously I need to provide the online switch there to make that happen with the current Windows image. And that lists all of the apps that are installed. Let's go and remove that Xbox Live Music app there. So let's just do remove Apex and select provision package again from the online image. And we'll provide the package name as the package name that's listed at the bottom here. Copy that, paste that down here, hit enter, and that's going to remove it for all future users on this device. If we go across to our start screen now, you'll see that actually the music app is still there, and we can go and still launch this application, because although we've removed it from the image, from the anybody else that's going to be logged onto this machine, they won't get the app. Any existing users will actually still keep the apps that have been provisioned for them. So this is the end of the PowerShell module here inside of the Modern Line of Business App Deployment MVA course. The next module that we're going to have a look at is going to look at the deployment of an app using System Center Configuration Manager 2012 Service Pack 1, and we're going to use that to deploy an app using sideloading out to a Windows 8 device.